Hello everyone, myself Kunal, and I am your mathematics tutor, and we are learning indefinite integral, and today is our last lecture of indefinite integral, which is lecture number 9. So let me write here. Today is our last lecture in which we will discuss some more cases of trigonometric इंटीग्रल सम स्पेशल केसेस जो हमने पहले से देखते आ रहे थे उसी में कुछ और आगे ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक इंटीग्रेशन हम लोग देखेंगे एंड वेयर वी एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास आई थिंक वी डिस्कस सम रिडक्शन फॉर्मूला एंड ऑल राइट वी डिस्कस सम रिडक्शन फॉर्मूला विच इज वी एंड विथ लाइक इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी एंड विथ रिडक्शन फॉर्मूला of tan to the power nx dx right this is our in so what's the reduction formula is in plus in minus 2 is equal to tan to the power n minus 1x by n minus 1 so this is our reduction formula of tan to the power nx right in today's lecture we go through some more trigonometric types and then we end the our chapter indefinite integration and by tomorrow lecture we start definite integral so let's begin the today's lecture with the type number what is called I guess it's 6 so type number 6 so how it look like our type number 6 look like sec to the power nx If somewhere like sec to the power nx is our integral where n belongs to any positive integer. Right. So there is two cases for that as well. N is either be even or n is either be even or odd. Right. So we have to go through the both of the cases. So our first case is if n is even. So if n is even, then what we have to do? Basically sec to the power nx, we first write it as sec to the power n minus 2x and sec square x. Right. And then convert this sec and sec to the power n minus 2x into the form of tan x and then convert it to tan x so this is our method for n is equal to even if given n is odd then just apply the bypass then just apply the bypass I hope you will understand this what I'm saying agar samajh nahi aa rahi hai to ye problem kya bolte hai example se samajh mein aa jayega so let's go through the example for first cases so our example one will something look like these are the procedure like if you find somewhere the integral look like sec to the power nx where if the n is odd so just apply the bypass and if the n is even just write just break it into two part first part second to the sec to the power n minus 2x and sec square x and then convert it to tan x right so let me give you example here a first type of this type right so if let us suppose we have to integrate sec to the power 6x sec to the power 6x dx so what you have to do first you have to actually you have to write it first sec to the power 4x and sec square x right dx and then what you have to do this term has to be converted into tan x you know that 1 plus tan square x whole square because x square x is 1 plus tan square x, right? So when we square it, we get the 1 plus 4 term. So this one, then x square x dx. Then nothing you have to do, just substitute tan x as t. So if you substitute tan x is equal to t, what we get? Let me write here. We get sec square x dx as dt. So we get 1 plus t square whole square, right? And this whole term as dt, right? I hope you'll all understand this, what I'm saying. And then just open that. So 1 plus t to the power 4 plus 2t square dt. And then just integrate it. So what we get? We get t plus t to the power 5 by 5 plus 2 by 3 t cube plus some constant. So this is our following integral for given integrand, right? And in last, you have to just substitute whatever we substitute in the following step. So tan t plus tan to the power 5. X actually 5 by 5 plus 2 by 3 tan cube x plus k. So this is my what I'm saying. So this is my integral. Now let's move on to the example for the odd one, right? Let us take the example for n is equal to odd. So whenever we take the for n is equal to odd, we have to apply bipartite, right? There is no other way, right? We have to just apply the bipartite. So let's move to the example. So take any sec to the power 5x. Let us check sec to the power 5x dx. Right. So here n is equal to 5, which is an odd. So we have to apply here by parts. So how we apply? First break it into sec cube x and sec square x dx, and then apply the by part. Okay. Take anyone as u, take anyone as v, because both function is algebraic function. So there is no preferential order or use of highlight here, because the both function is trigonometric function, right? So let's start the integration. So I is equal to sec to the power 5x dx is equal to what we get here. First, take its outside, say cube x tan x minus, when we differentiate it, we get 3 sec square x, sec x, and then tan x, and then tan x dx, right? Okay. Now I is equal to, here we get sec cube x tan x minus, this will create our 3i plus 3 sec cube x dx. Okay, so now what I have to do, take it on left hand side, so we get 4i and sec square sec cube x tan x plus 3, again break it into two parts, which will look like sec x and sec square x, and again apply the by part. So it will be like sec cube x tan x plus 3 by 2 sec x tan x, and you know, differentiation integration of sec x is ln sec x plus tan x. So this is our final result, a final integral. I hope you'll all understand. अगर समझ में नहीं आया मैं एक बार फिर से समझा देता हूँ. So what is our given integral? So our given integral is sec to the power 5x, right? Our given integral is sec to the power 5x, where power is odd, right? So we have to apply the biparts only here. So what I'm doing is I'm just applying biparts by taking u and v as sec x itself. Okay, so when we do such thing, what we get actually, we first apply here. So we first take outside the sec x and then integrate the sec square x, and we know the integration of sec square x is tan x, right? So it will be occur here tan x, and then we have to differentiate the u. So when we differentiate sec cube x, we get 3 sec square x, 3 sec square x sec x tan x, right? Because we have to applying the chain rule here, and then we know the integration of sec square is tan x. So iski integration jo hai wo yahan pe aayi hai, right? And then we rearrange it, so we get the same thing, sec to the power 5x. So now again we have to apply the biparts here for sec cube x. So when we apply here biparts again, it something leads to sec x sec square x, and again biparts here. So sec x will be outside, so integration of sec square x is tan x, and again here the tan x term, and when you differentiate it, it will automatically come out to ln sec x. I hope you'll all understand what I'm trying to say. Let's move on to the next type actually. So our next type is something look like this time type 8. Sec to the power nx into tan to the power nx. Right, sec to the power nx, tan to the power nx, where obviously n belongs to the positive integer. So what you have to do, you have to just take, these are procedures, so you have to just follow these procedure for solving in a just 2 to 3 line, right? You have to just follow this procedure what I'm writing here. So just take sec square x and try to convert rest into the term of tan x. Try to convert the rest in term of tan x. Okay, where n belongs to the even. This has to be noted. And second, take sec x tan x and y, use by parts. Okay, when the n is even, then try to convert, try to take out sec square x and try to convert rest into the term of tan x. And for n is even, take sec x tan x and use by parts. I hope you'll all understand. So let's move to the example and try to understand. So our example is sec to the power 6x tan to the power 4x dx. So what we have to do, we have to just write sec square x here, and so there will be sec to the power 4x, tan to the power 4x dx. Convert this sec to the power 4x into tan form, so 1 plus tan square x whole square, and there will be like tan to the power 4x as well, there is sec square x dx. And you know the next step, अभी तक कितनी बार हमने सॉल्व करा है पता चल गया होगा. व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट tan x इज इक्वल टू t, एंड व्हेन वी डू सो वी गेट सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स इक्वल टू डी टी राइट सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स इक्वल टू डी टी एंड देन जस्ट मूव ऑन टू द एवब इंटीग्रल सो आवर इंटीग्रल लुक लाइक 1 plus t square to the whole square 2 to the power 4 dt right and just open it so what we get t to the power 4 plus just multiply it inside of it t to the power 8 plus 2 to the power 6 dt so we get t to the power 5 by 5 plus t to the power 9 by 9 plus t to the actually 2 by 7 right 2 by 7 t to the power 7 plus some constant and then just substitute the whatever we get here so what we have to substitute here tan so just write here tan to the power 5x by 5 tan to the power 9x by 9 plus 2 by 7 tan to the power 7x plus some constant. So this is our final product. Right. I hope you'll all understand. So let's move on to the next type. Right. This is actually important for JE Mains and JE Advanced purpose as well. So this is important. So this is type number, what is 7 or 8? 7, 8, whatever. So it is something look like, so so this is our next type will something look like as a sine x plus, minus cos x divided by some f of sine 2x function. And another sine 2x is, so let me write here first. So this is our function type. So we know that sine 2x is 2 sine x cos x, right? We know that the sine 2x is 2 sine x cos x. So what you have to just do, we can write 2 sine x cos x as sine x plus cos x whole square minus 1 or we can write it as 1 minus sine x minus cos x whole square because when we expand it we know that the sine square plus cos square term is 1 right sine square plus cos square term is 1 so we just get one so we get the favorable result so this is so this one thing you have to use here wherever sine 2x or 2 sine x cos x you saw you have to just use this term and the second term we have to solve the differentiation so the differentiation like in such a way if sine plus cos I show you the shorthand notation of sine x so you can use for big problem. So sine x plus cos x differentiation is cos x minus sine x and sine x minus cos x differentiation is cos x plus sine x. Cos x plus sine x. I hope you'll understand. So let's use this all form, whatever I write here into problem. So this is TJ clear. So let's write it. So our question one will something look like dx by cos x. Plus cos x. Right. So we have to find the integral of this. So what we have to do? If we do some simplification here, So what we get, cos x plus cos x, we can write it into 1 by sin x, right? And when we solve this, what we get, sin x dx, we get here sin x cos x plus 1. Right. So if you notice that we get the sin x cos x term here. Right. So if we multiply and divide by 2, enumerator and denominator. So what we get, let me write here. Let me multiply by 2 sin x in numerator, basically 2 by numerator and 2 by denominator. So it's something look like sin 2x plus 2. And we know that. And we can write this sin x as if we subtract and add cos x. So it's changed nothing. So we can write as sin plus cos minus cos minus sin dx. And we can write it into 2 plus sin 2x. Right. And we know that we can write this sin 2x as 2 term. Either we can write it into sin plus cos whole square minus 1, or we can write it into 1 minus sin minus cos whole square, right? And we know that the differentiation of sin plus cos is cos minus sin, and sin minus cos is cos plus sin. So we have to create, so first we have to write this into two part. Let me write here. First we have to write sin 2 sin 2x. And then we have to write cos minus sin by 2 plus sin 2x dx, right? And then we can write this sin 2x as sin minus cos. So the differentiation of sin minus cos is cos plus sin, right? So just write it into sin plus cos dx and 2 plus, basically they will be written as 1 minus. So there will be like 3 minus here come. Okay, let me erase it. So here will be like 3 minus sin minus cos whole square. And we can write this sin 2x as cos minus sin and sin plus cos whole square minus 1. So when we do minus 1, it comes from plus 1. And then we have to. So if we notice that, if we substitute this as f, so this is our df. And this is f, so this is our df. So this is simply our function df by f integration. So we know that df by f integration is df by a square minus f square function, right? Right, df by a square minus f square function. So we know the differentiation. Integration of such function is 1 by 2a ln a minus f by a plus f, right? So just apply here. So we know that. So here a is 1 by 2 root 3, because we can write this as root 3 square. We can write this as 1 square. So 1 by 2 root 3 log of root 3 plus sin x minus cos x divided by root 3 minus sin x plus cos x. I hope you'll all understand what I'm trying to say is, right? And this integral is form integration of df by a square plus x square. So what you have to do simply, you have to just use the tan inverse form. So tan inverse of x by a. So a value is 1. So 1 by 1, that will be remain 1. And here is to apply tan inverse x by a. So it will be sine plus cos. लेट मी राइट हियर इन अ क्लियर वे, 1/2 √3 ln mod of 3 plus sin x minus cos x divided by √3 minus sin x plus cos x minus tan inverse of sin x plus cos x, right? So this is our final integral. I hope you'll all understand what I'm done here is, look, let me explain again. So this is if our integrand look like sine x plus minus cos x and divided by some sine 2x function and some constant p here. Okay, so what you have to do, just we have to just substitute sine 2x at into a such function such that its differentiation will be created in numerator. So we know that we can write sine 2x as into two form, like either we can write sine plus cos whole square minus 1, or we can write it into like 1 minus sine minus cos whole square. And we know the differentiation of sine x plus cos x is cos x minus sine x, and sine x minus cos x is cos x plus sine x. So we can use this differentiation concept into our numerator to solve the integrand, right? So I just use the same concept, and like our problem given is cos x plus cos x. So first I do some simplification. We can write cos x as 1 by sin x, and then sin x plus cos x plus 1, and then this sin x goes to the numerator. So here create the sin 2x term, and I just repeat the all procedure of type 7 or 8, whatever it is, into this question, and it and our integrand gate. So just I'm saying is ki if somewhere this kind of integrand is appear, so you have to just follow the same concept. Okay, I hope you'll all understand what I'm saying. Let's move on to the next problem. And this problem is actually simple. It's something look like integration of sine of ln x plus cos of ln x dx. Okay, so you have to integrate this. So we know that what we have to do, we know that the differentiation of sine x function, not sine ln x, sine x function is cos x, right? Sine x function is cos x, and here cos x with same function is written. So, and the differentiation of ln x is 1 by x. So what if sine of ln x plus cos of ln x x into 1 by x I do? We can write 1 into is equal to x into 1 by x, right? We can write. So I just write it here, and now I notice that if this is our f function, so this whole function is our f dash function, and if this is our g function, so there is written is 1, so this is our g dash function. So what we get a g dash f plus f dash g, and we already read this form. This is a special integrand, classic integrand, so we can write it into h. So its integration is fg, right? And what is our f function? Our f function is sine of ln x on the x plus some constant, right? So this is our फॉलोइंग विजिट, लेट मी राइट इट क्लियरली, एफ जी प्लस सम कॉन्स्टेंट। ओके, सो वी कैन राइट इनटू सर्च फॉर्म। ओके, नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट टाइप। एक्चुअली आई थिंक वी कैन डू सम प्रॉब्लम एज वेल। सो देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम विच लुक लाइक, लेट मी राइट हियर, लेट मी प्रॉब्लम, हाँ, सो इट्स समथिंग लुक लाइक आई इज इक्वल टू सिक्स स्क्वायर एक्स डिवाइडेड बाय सेक एक्स प्लस टेन एक्स टू द पावर 9/2 dx। ओके, 9/2 dx। सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू टू सॉल्व दिस, लाइक हाउ टू अप्रोच। सो लाइक फर्स्ट वी हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट इट इनटू लाइक सेक एक्स प्लस टेन एक्स एज टी, राइट? सो व्हाट वी गेट इफ वी सब्स्टिट्यूट सेक एक्स प्लस टेन एक्स एज टी, सो if we differentiate it, right, if we differentiate it, what we get, like sec x differentiation will be sec x tan x, and tan x differentiation will be sec square x, and then dx is equal to dt। यहाँ तक तो चीजें क्लियर हो रही होंगी। लाइक वी जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट सेक एक्स प्लस टेन एक्स एज टी, सो बिकॉज वी हैव टू टेक समहाउ आउट ऑफ द रूट, राइट? सो आई जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट द सेक एक्स प्लस टेन एक्स इज इक्वल टू टू एंड देन जस्ट डिफरेंशिएट इट, सो वी गेट दिस फॉर्म। नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, our integrand is actually, let me write here, let me write here, our integrand is sec square x divided by sec x plus tan x to the power 9/2, so there is root 2, right? So what you have to do now, just writing sec square x divided by, because if because we have to create here something, otherwise we can't do anything with our this dx format. So let me write here sec x plus tan x to the power 9/2, and we can write it as if we take sec x common. So what we get? We get tan x plus sec x dx is equal to dt, right? And we know that if the sec x plus tan x is equal to t, so sec x minus tan x is equal to 1/t. Right? Are you getting that? If not, then let's see. Like sec square x minus tan square x is equal to 1. So if we get sec x plus tan x and sec x minus tan x, so if the sec x plus tan x is t, so sec x minus tan x is 1/t. Right? So from there I will get. So if we solve that, what we get? Sec x is equal to वी गेट टी प्लस वन बाई टी डिवाइडेड बाई टू टी टू द पावर 9/2 टी डी टी एंड वी हैव टू इंटीग्रेट दिस. नाउ वॉट यू हैव टू डू द जस्ट डिवाइडेड थ्रू. सो वी गेट डी टी बाई टी टू द पावर 9/2 प्लस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी टी बाई e to the power 13/2, right? And when we do so, what we get? Minus 1/7 e to the power minus 7/2 minus 1/11 t to the power minus 11/2 and plus some constant. So this is our following integral. I hope you'll all understand what I am saying is, and let's move to the one more example. That is the last example of today, and then we recall ki humne kya kya padha, because the map is very necessary. Like हमने क्या क्या पढ़ा नहीं पढ़ा, दैट इज द मोस्ट नेसेसरी थिंग. सो लेट मी टेक एग्जांपल हियर. लुक समथिंग लुक लाइक व्हाट इज इट, आई एम नॉट गेटिंग. हाँ, सो आवर एग्जांपल इज sec x, नॉट sec x. हाँ, दिस इज आवर एग्जांपल, दिस इज आवर लास्ट एग्जांपल. Our sine 101x dot sine to the power 99 x dx, right? So we have to find the integral of this. This is not in power. Let me write it clearly. It is written in sine 101x dot sine to the power 99x and dx. Now what I have to do, I have to just write it as sine 100x plus x, this 101 plus x, we can write it into this form, and then you have to apply the sine a plus b formula, which is like sin a cos b cos a sin b, right? So we can write it into sin 100x cos x and plus cos 100x sin x, and then we just apply the biparts here. So what we can write, sin 100x dot cos x sin 99x and dx plus cos 100x sine to the power 100x dx, right? And then you have to do nothing, you have to just go through by applying biparts. So sine 100x cos x sine to the power 99x dx minus d by dx, we can write it into this form, sine of 100, differentiation of sine of 100x and integration of cos to the power cos x and sine to the power 99x dx plus cos 100 into sine to the power 900x, right? So what we do here, when we solve this, we get sine 100x, and this integration will be like sine to the power 100x by 100, because if we substitute sine 99 as t, sine x as t, so this will form the dt term, so its integration will be sine 100x to the power 100 minus 100 dot cos 100x sine to the power 100x by 100 dx plus cos 100 x sine to the power 100 x dx, right? So this will get cancelled with same sign, same value with opposite sign, right? So this will get cancelled. So we get the favorable result of sine 100 x dot sine 100 x to the 5, 100 plus some constant. So this is our favorable integral. So this is our last problem. Let me make you a mind map for you, like how to solve the each and every single problem of integral. So this is important. So first you have to know some, so we have to, okay, we have to go through some first. So we have to know some basic formula here. We have basic property, technique. You have to know, like jo humne bataya tha, which is substitution, by parts, and partial fraction, and some manipulation. Right, you have to know this. The next thing we have to know, standard basic algebraic integral. The next thing you have to know is proper and important trigonometric substitution. Right. And the last two thing is cases based algebraic and trigonometric integrand. So this whole thing we cover, and if you practice this all, you get and most important things in this, practice a lot, practice make you perfect in this chapter. Okay. So by next class, we're starting definite integral, in which we have to just put limit and some more property in it. It has more properties. So in tomorrow lecture, we start definite integration. Thank you.